Have a seat on the Animus, Desmond.
When you are exposed, throwing soldiers from roof.
I'll have your head. Come back here!
Come on and fight!
There he goes! Stop him! You're mine!
Guard won't take action. It falls to us to do something.
What you propose is madness.
But necessary. How many more will we allow to go missing before the people take a stand?
It does not affect us.
Not yet. But if we continue to do nothing, it will.
And what do you propose?
I've watched the man. Learned everything there is to know about his operation. It's all here on a map I've made. He inspects his stock every day at the same time. This is when I'll strike.
So you have a piece of paper. It won't save you when you're discovered. Won't shield you from their swords and arrows.
If all goes well, it won't come to that. Anyway, it's a risk I'll have to take. Wish me luck, my friend.
Indeed. You'll need it.
Someone else.
Need something?
I wonder where he is.
Leave this place.
I have many things, many things. Do anything.
You seem to know exactly what you want. I like that in a customer.
What is it that you want?
Altair! It seems I've made some enemies. Al-Mualim asked that I shadow the slave trader, and I did, though not well enough. He discovered me, and I've been running from his men ever since. I need to get out of the city, but I can't do it alone. Help me, and I'll share what I've learned with you.
Talal provides. Talal understands your pain. What you lack, he will provide. All that is asked is an honest day's work.
Thank you, brother. Take this map. It lists Talal's hiding places. Useful information should that coward choose to run instead of fight. And from what I know of the man, run is what he'll do.
In which we live. Food is scarce, money tight, but it need not be this way. There are opportunities for those with the courage to seize them. Who knows what the future holds, what tragedies tomorrow may bring. Defend against an uncertain future. Protect the ones you love. Work hard, and you will be rewarded. Talal provides.
Have mercy on your soul.
How simple.
This won't be too difficult. How can one expect to defeat me?
I have nothing to say to you.
Speak to me or speak to God. It's your choice.
You won't stop the work he does. Cannot stop it.
Stop what? What work?
He prepares them for the journey.
Journey where?
They are held in his warehouse. And when the time comes, they are sent to Akka.
Where is this warehouse? And why Akka?
Talal tells me what I need to know. Nothing more. It is safer that way.
For him, perhaps. Though not, I fear, for you.
Away with you. You shouldn't be here. Be gone. Is there a reason for this nonsense?
Is there a reason for him to do that?
Thinking.
You've no reason to stand here. Leave.
A coward. If it wasn't for the money, I'd be long gone.
You're either stupid or blind. Maybe it's both.
How can you say that?
You didn't see what happened.
I saw well enough. Our caravan was attacked, and the first thing he did was flee.
No, he didn't run.
What are you talking about?
Do you forget what became of the men who attacked us?
Felled by our archers, thanks be to God.
Not our archers, him, alone.
So you're saying he saved us?
Yes, he headed for higher ground, and used his bow to kill them.
I had no idea.
The man's a master archer. You'd do well to remember that.
What? Who's done this? Tell me!
We shouldn't be running like that. Why is he running? Please, sir, have any money.
Where is he going? Let me show you everything I have.
Why would he do that?
Anything you like?
Just an old man.
You there! Yes, you! Come!
Safety and peace, Altair. We live in harsh times, do we not? I am in an ocean of trouble. I had a mission to investigate some strange disappearances in the Rich District, and Talal's men saw my face. My status is compromised. Would you be kind enough to eliminate them for me in exchange for the information you seek?
I am at your service. Listen here, citizens. If you're tired of shoddy food, then come see me. My merchandise is without fear. Anything you like?
Ones who knew me? Excellent. Here's what I learned about Talal. He's a powerful slaver who occupies an area north of town, near the Barbican. He pays a tribute to the city guards so he can operate in the shadows. But from what you showed me today, I'm sure he will share the same fate as the others. Thank you again, Altair.
Safety and peace, Malik.
Your presence here deprives me of both. What do you want?
Al-Muallim has asked.
Ask that you perform some menial task in an effort to redeem yourself. So be out with it.
Very well. Here's what I know. He traffics in human lives, kidnapping Jerusalem citizens and selling them into slavery. His base is a warehouse located inside the Barbican, north of here. As we speak, he prepares a caravan for travel. I'll strike while he's inspecting his stock. If I can avoid his men, Talal himself should prove little challenge.
Little challenge? Listen to you. Such arrogance.
Are we finished? Are you satisfied with what I've learned?
No. But it will have to do. Rest, prepare, cry in the corner. Do whatever it is you do before a mission. Only make sure you do it quietly.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
Thank you.
come no further. You're a dead man.
You'll never get away. I know you're hiding from me.
Me.
You can hide from me. There he is! I'll take you down! I will find you!
But I say, this is an order!
What now, slaver?
Do not call me that. I only wish to help them, as I myself was helped.
You do no kindness imprisoning them like this.
Imprisoning
help
them?
Help me! I keep them safe!
Save me! Preparing them for the journey that lies ahead.
What journey? It is a life of servitude.
You know nothing. It was folly to even bring you here. To think that you might see and understand.
I understand well enough. Show yourself.
Ah, so you want to see the man who called you here?
You did not call me here. I came on my own.
Did you? Who unbarred the door? Cleared the path? Did you once raise your blade against a single man of mine, huh? No. All this I did for you. Step into the light, then, and I will grant you one final favor. Now I stand before you. What is it you desire?
Come down here. Let us settle this with honor.
Why must it always come to violence? It seems I cannot help you, for you do not wish to help yourself. And I cannot allow my work to be threatened. You leave me no choice. You must die. This will teach you not to trespass.
Seni gözüm kapalı bile yeter.
Die, infidel! You'll never get away!
with you!
Keep him away from me!
Nowhere to run now. Share your secrets with me.
My part is played. The Brotherhood is not so weak that my death will stop its work.
What Brotherhood?
Al-Mualim is not the only one with designs upon the Holy Land. And that's all you'll have from me.
Then we are finished. Beg forgiveness from your god.
He's long abandoned us. Long abandoned the men and women I took into my arms.
What do you mean?
Beggars, whores, addicts, lepers. Do they strike you as proper slaves? Unfit for even the most menial tasks? No. I took them not to sell, but to save. And yet you'd kill us all. For no other reason than it was asked of you.
No. You profit from the war. From lives lost and broken.
Yes, you would think that, ignorant as you are. Wall off your mind. They say it's what your kind do best. Do you see the irony in all this? No, not yet, it seems. But you will.
Altair! Wonderful to see you return to us! And how fared the mission?
The deed is done. Talal is dead.
Oh, I know, I know. In fact, the entire city knows! Have you forgotten the meaning of subtlety?
A skilled assassin ensures his work is noticed by the many.
No! A skilled assassin maintains control of his environment.
We can argue the details all you'd like, Malik. But the fact remains, I've accomplished the task set to me by Al-Muallim.
Go then. Return to the old man. Let us see with whom he sides.
You and I are on the same side, Malik.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
going to pay! Everywhere they run!
God damn it! What's the problem now?
I'm getting weird temperature readings. I think the Animus is overheating.
Christ, it's always something! How long?
Too soon to tell.
These delays are unacceptable, Miss Stillman. I want progress reports every hour.
It's gonna be a while, Desmond. Why don't you go lie down or something? Get some rest.
Why is he always yelling at you? It's his machine.
His theories. He's not the one who built it.
Who did? You?
No. Abstergo has a team of engineers. Not much they don't have. But I did oversee the assembly. Guess that's why he gets so angry with me.
He's a dick.
He's under a lot of pressure. We all are.
I can't believe you're defending the guy.
Warren saved my life, so if he wants to yell a little, let him.
What do you mean he saved your life?
You're not the only one who doesn't get to go home at night.
Wait, are you saying you're a prisoner?
When they first approached me, I was finishing up my PhD. The university had made it clear I had no future there. They didn't like the subject of my doctorate, called it pseudoscience. Said keeping me on would discredit and embarrass them. It was the same everywhere. Other universities, companies I interviewed with. Pretty soon I was out of money and out of time. I was this close to waiting tables. Then I got a letter.
From Vidic?
He said he'd been following my career since undergrad, that he believed in my work and wanted to meet to discuss my future. You have no idea how good it felt to hear that. So I met with him. What did I have to lose?
And he offered you a job?
Yes, here at Abstergo, helping out on the Animus project. I'd have a chance to test my theories and prove the professor's wrong. How could I turn that down?
I think I'm missing the part where you became a prisoner.
Sometimes I wonder if they weren't behind it all. If they manipulated events so that I'd get desperate. They can do that. They can do anything. I didn't think when I agreed to come here. They even told me I'd be trapped. For 6 months, a year max. Once the product launched, there'd be no need for secrecy anymore. But until then, I'd be a guest of the company. At least, that's what they said.
And when the Animus was ready?
They came in while I was sleeping. Three guys. Guns. They dragged me out of bed. God. The worst part is I knew them. One guy... They were cracking jokes. I tried to pull away. He hit me. And that's when he told me I was going to die.
Christ, what did you do?
Nothing. I kept telling myself it wasn't real. And then Warren was there, shouting at them to get away from me. And they listened.
Jesus.
He's not a happy man, Desmond. I wouldn't even say he's a good man, but he saved my life. They never came for me again. And he promised they never would.
You're still stuck here working for these nutjobs.
But I'm alive. Anyway, I really do need to get the Animus repaired. I'll see you tomorrow, Desmond. Aren't you tired? Can't talk. Gotta work. Aren't you tired?
What the hell? Someone's been in here. Looks like some kind of access code.
Rise and shine. We've got quite a day ahead of us.
You're in a good mood this morning.
Miss Stillman has made some modifications to the Animus. You should be able to remain inside even longer now.
And help you with your treasure hunt.
This is serious business, Mr. Miles. I don't think you fully appreciate the work that Abstergo does.
Maybe because I don't actually know what you people do.
We change the world. Every day, in 100 different ways. Did you know that nearly every single breakthrough of the past millennia, be it medical, mechanical, or philosophical, has come from Abstergo or its predecessors?
That's a bold claim, Doc. Think you might be exaggerating a bit?
Not in the slightest. Oh, we certainly don't take the credit. That would arouse far too much suspicion. We choose our beneficiaries with great care.
Why?
Isn't it obvious? It means we're in control.
But how? What makes you guys so special, so smart, that you happen to invent all these things while us mere mortals stumble around like idiots?
To be fair, we don't invent them. We find them.
Find them?
They're gifts, Mr. Miles. From those who came before. We'll have to continue this discussion later. Time's wasting.
Morning, Desmond.
Yeah. Hi.
Lie down already!
Take your time. When moving slowly...
Come in, Altair. You've done well. Three of the Nine lay dead, and for this you have my thanks. But do not think to rest upon your laurels. Your work has just begun.
I am yours to command, Master.
King Richard, emboldened by his victory at Arca, prepares to move south towards Jerusalem. Salah ad-Din is surely aware of this. And so he gathers his men before the broken citadel of Arsuf.
Would you have me kill them both then? End their war before it begins in earnest?
No. To do so would scatter their forces and subject the realm to the bloodlust of 10,000 aimless warriors. It will be many days before they meet, and while they march, they do not fight. You must concern yourself with a more immediate threat. The men who pretend to govern in their absence.
Give me names and I'll give you blood.
So I will. Abu Nukud, the wealthiest man in Damas, Majduddin, regent of Jerusalem, William of Montferrat, liege lord of Acre.
What are their crimes?
Greed, arrogance, the slaughter of innocents. Walk amongst the people of their cities. You'll learn the secrets of their sins. Do not doubt that these men are obstacles to the peace we seek.
Then they will die.
Another of your items is restored. Take it. See that it is put to good use. Return to me as each man falls, that we might better understand their intentions. And Altair, take care. Your recent work has likely attracted the attention of the city guard. They'll be more suspicious than they've been in the past.
Altair,
It seems my students do not fully understand what it is to wield the blade. Perhaps you could show them what you know. Perfect. The work of a master. That, my students, is how we all should fight. You must be busy. I understand.
Such wild swings will give your enemy an opening and send you to an early death.
Use throwing knives to deal with distant enemies.
Anything I can help you with, anything at all, do not...
Have you gone mad?
I am in the right place! There's no better merchant than I!
I have many things, many things, too many things!
For what we believe in, there is no greater glory than this.
Why would he even do so?
So comes the English king and his infidel organization. They leave horror. Make no mistake.
What is he
a few coins. All I ask is for a few coins.
Do you think he
please
thinks
he's spicy? Help me!
Any good?
kime boyun eğmek istiyorsun?
You're mine!
Thank you. Thank you. I'll find a way to repay this kindness, I swear it.
Warning! Should Richard take Jaffa, there will be no stopping him! I stand before you to deliver a warning! Should Richard take Jaffa, there will be no stopping him! He will march on Jerusalem next! We must end this before it has a chance to begin! That city is ours, has always been ours! And it is our duty to defend it until death! The Crusader must be destroyed!
Again!
Come back!
Take your time. When moving slowly,
did you see that?
Yes!
You wish to die?
I will end your life.
You're mine!
Not helping.
Kime boyunaymak istiyorsun? Geber kafir! Kime boyun eğmek istiyorsun?
I have nothing.
Why would anyone do that?
No, please don't leave. Just a few coins, please.
The last of it has been delivered.
Good. Make sure he also knows it wasn't easy arranging a shipment like this.
It's only wine. Some can be fickle in their faith.
Your holy book says something on the subject, I believe. Leave them that they may eat and enjoy themselves, and that hope may beguile them, for they will soon know. And never did we destroy a town that had a term made known.
What's that supposed to mean?
Never mind it. Be about your business.
As you wish.
Brother, it's been such a long time. Any news of Ada since she left? No. How sad. I'm sure you'll find her someday. I have heard a feather is lying on top of Abulnukud's head. Maybe I could help you, but I have a mission myself. I have 4 targets I must eliminate before noon. Let's cooperate, just like old times. 2 for you, 2 for me. They are Abulnukud's personal guards. You will spot them in minutes.
I beg of you, just a few coins. My family is sick and dying. Could you spare a few coins? Huh? No, you don't understand. I have nothing.
Something caught your eye?
Did you not see me here?
Who wasn't that great? Just like in Alep, you remember? Here's something I found on one of the Merchant King's men. I think it's a map of where he has stationed his guards. I'm sure it will come in handy in your mission. Anytime you're in Damask, come see me. You know my door is always open to you. Safety and peace, my friend.
Forbidden for you to be here. You are not supposed to be here. Leave. To be here. I'll get you.
Why would
someone
he do
tell
that?
Me why he's doing that.
I don't understand what he's trying.
Get away from me!
It was good of you to come.
It is an honor to serve. What do you require?
The letter I've given you must be brought to Salah ad-Din's camp. Seek out the one they call Hisham. He will be able to help. But tell no one else of this.
None will know my mission.
Then our business is concluded.
Thank you.
God save him! He's gone mad!
Could I interview you in this ship too?
Would you spare a few coins?
What would cost
you? Please, sir, have any money?
Altair, my friend. Welcome, welcome. Whose life do you come to collect today?
His name is Abu Nakud.
Oh, the merchant king of Damas, richest man in the city. Quite exciting, quite dangerous. I envy you, Altair. Well, not the bit where you were beaten and stripped of your rank, but I envy everything else. Oh, except for the terrible things the other assassins say about you. But yes, aside from the failure and the hatred, yes, aside from those things, I envy you very much.
If you're finished, I've gathered the information required to begin my task.
You work quickly. Tell me what you've learned.
Abu Nakud is corrupt to the core and despised by his own citizens as a result. It appears he's been stealing money meant for the people of Damas and spending it on himself. Even as we speak, he flaunts his greed, preparing for a lavish party. His guards and servants should have their hands full dealing with the guests. They won't even know him there.
Most impressive, my friend. The others said you'd make a mess of things, but not I. No, I was sure you'd come through, and come through you have. The bureau is yours to do with as you please until you're ready to begin.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one.
What would make someone move so quickly?
Maybe if
you just what is that man thinking?
What is he doing?
Thank you all for joining me this evening. Please eat, drink, enjoy all the pleasures I have to offer. Take your time, I will wait. I trust everything is to your satisfaction.
Most excellent, most excellent.
Good, good. It pleases me to see you all so happy. For these are dark days, my friends, and we must enjoy this bounty while we still can. War threatens to consume us all. Salah ad-Din bravely fights for what he believes in, and you are always there to support him without question. It is your generosity that allows his campaign to continue. So, I propose a toast then. To you, my dear friend. You have brought us to where we are today. May you be given everything you deserve for it. Such kindness! I didn't think it in you. You, who have been so quick to judge me, and so cruel. Oh, do not feign ignorance. You take me for a fool. That I have not heard the words you whisper behind my back. Well, I have, and I fear I can never forget. But this is not why I called you here tonight, no. I wish to speak more of this war, and your part in it. You give up your coin quick as can be, knowing all too well it buys the deaths of thousands. You don't even know why we fight. The sanctity of the Holy Land, you'll say, or the evil inclination of our enemies. But these are lies you tell yourselves. No, all this suffering is born of fear and hate. It bothers you that they are different, just as it bothers you that I am different. Compassion, mercy, tolerance. These words mean nothing to any of you, mean nothing to those infidel invaders who ravage our land in search of gold and glory. And so I say, enough! I've pledged myself to another cause, one that will bring about a new world in which all people might live side by side in peace. A pity none of you will live to see it. Kill anyone who tries to escape.
Get away from me!
peace now. Their words can no longer do harm.
Why have you done this?
You stole money from those you claim to lead, sent it away for some unknown purpose. I want to know where it's gone and why.
Look at me. My very nature is an affront to the people I ruled. And these noble robes did little more than to muffle their shouts of hate.
So this is about vengeance, then?
No, not vengeance, but my conscience. How could I finance a war in service to the same god that calls me an abomination?
If you do not serve Salah ad-Din's cause, then whose?
In time, you'll come to know them. I think perhaps you already do.
Then why hide? And why these dark deeds?
Is it so different from your own work? You take the lives of men and women, strong in the conviction that their deaths will improve the lots of those left behind. A minor evil for a greater good? We are the same.
No, we are nothing alike.
Ah, but I see it in your eyes. You doubt. You cannot stop us. We will have our new world.
أيها الكافر، سوف تموت هنا.
Geber, kafir!
Has reached me of your success, Altair.
Abu Nakud's reign of terror is at an end.
I'm glad to hear it.
He killed them. The men and women at his party. It was poison. A coward's tool. Blamed them for the war. Said he wished to end it.
Strange, but then again, the Merchant King was known to be a bit different. Perhaps this was simply a symptom of his madness.
Perhaps.
You sound unconvinced. Speak with Al-Mualim then. He may offer a better explanation.
Yes, we'll see what he has to say.
Fast forwarding memory to a more recent one. When you are exposed, throwing soldiers from roof.
Come, Altair. Speak with me a moment.
As you wish.
Word has reached me of your success. You've my gratitude and that of the realm. Freeing these cities from their corrupt leaders will no doubt promote the cause of peace.
Can you really be so sure?
The means by which men rule are reflected in their people. As you cleanse the cities of corruption, you heal the hearts and minds of those who live within.
Our enemies would disagree.
What do you mean?
Each man I've slain has confessed strange words to me. They are without regret. Even in death, they seem confident of their success. Though they do not admit it directly, there is a tie that binds them. I'm sure of it.
There is a difference, Altair, between what we are told to be true and what we see to be true. Most men do not bother to make the distinction. It is simpler that way. But as an assassin, it is your nature to notice, to question.
Then what is it that connects these men?
Ah, but as an assassin, it is also your duty to still these thoughts and trust in your master. For there can be no true peace without order, and order requires authority.
You speak in circles, master. You commend me for being aware, then ask me not to be. Which is it?
The question will be answered when you no longer need to ask it.
I assume you called me here for more than just a lecture.
Very well. A rank and weapon are again restored to you. Two more leaders remain. Go and see to it that their rule is ended.
Better not cause any trouble.
Altair, it seems my students do not fully understand what it is to wield a blade. Perhaps you could show them what you know. the work of a master. That, my students, is how we all should fight. You must be busy. I understand.
Is he running from someone?
Remember to reach out for ledges should you fall.
I got one. fortune favors me today. God only knows what foul deeds those men intended to commit. Good of you to arrive when you did, stranger. I'll see to it that my husband hears of your bravery.
Heathen! This is where you die! You... Keep up with it! Don't let it get away!
They let you come and go as you please. I thought the fortress was closed to all.
Aye, but William wishes to have repairs completed as soon as possible. It's been to our advantage.
The perfect cover. It's clever.
Anyway, I've finished my report and should deliver it.
For once, it seems things might go our way, and not by accident.
Well, the Bible does say God helps those who help themselves.
Nah, it doesn't, actually. That's from one of Aesop's fables. The Bible says quite the opposite, in fact. Many passages of being patient and faithful and waiting for the Lord to decide if he wishes to assist.
Well, I say we've waited long enough.
You'll hear no argument from me.
Very well. I'm off then.
Fight!
How dare you! God!
See!
He should stop acting like a child. What is that man thinking?
Do you think he's being chased by someone?
He's gonna hurt himself, and when he does, I won't help him.
Rodoha Alley!
Thank you.